Last time, what we have seen in last week and in last 2 weeks, what we have seen the what are the fins, what is the function of fins. Then we have seen the type of fins. First, we have seen infinitely long fins, temperature distribution, and heat transfer for the infinitely long fins. Then we have seen the long fins with insert tips. Okay, then we have also seen the temperature distribution and heat transfer from the base of the fin for the inserted fins. Okay, then we have seen how the fins are classified according to the ML ratio, है ना? And if ML is less than 3, there is called a short fin. Then we have seen the temperature distribution and the heat transfer for the short fin also. Then we took the some problem on the short fins, isn't it? Almost we have taken two or three problem on short fins. Now today we will see some variety of problems. Okay. Now this is the problem. Today's first problem. Now here we have given two cases for insulated tip. We have given two cases. Fins are provided to increase the heat transfer rate from the hot surface. Which of the following arrangement will be useful? Okay, so we have given the two arrangement. We have to find out which arrangement will be useful. Six fins with 10 centimeter length or 10 fins with 6 centimeter length. This we need to find out. For both fins, the thermal conductivity is around 300 watt per meter Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient is 20 watt per meter square Kelvin. The cross-sectional area for both cases is 2 centimeter square. Perimeter of the fin for both cases is 4 centimeter. Temperature of the hot surface means T naught is 230 degrees Celsius. And ambient temperature, it is nearly around 30 degree Celsius. Okay, so here we have to assume the fins with insulated ends, and we need to find out of these two cases which out of these two arrangement which arrangement will give you the highest heat transfer. Okay, so for this, what we need to assume the fin with the insulated ends, area, perimeter, KH, all will be same. Only number of fins and length of the fin will change. So can you tell me the answer out of these two cases, which will give the highest heat transfer? So first we need to find out the value of M. Okay, M is equal to what? You know, PH divided by KA. Perimeter is 4 centimeter, means 0.04 meter. Heat transfer coefficient is 20. The thermal conductivity is 300 watt per meter Kelvin, and the cross sectional area is 4 centimeter, means 2 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. So M is roughly around 3.65. Okay, 3.65. Then it first case, heat transfer rate Q1 from the 6 fins and 10 centimeter length. Okay, so what is the formula for heat transfer? HP K theta 0 tan HML. This is the heat transfer formula for insulated tip into number of N, means number of fins are 6. Okay, so you have to put all the values. You have to put all the values here. So Q1 is equal to number of fins are 6, H is 20, P is 0.04, K is 300, area is 2 into the power minus 4 meter square. What is theta 0 here? What is theta 0? Excess temperature is theta 0. It is what? T0 minus T infinity. So it is 230 है ना, बेस टेम्परेचर इज 230 माइनस 30, तो इट इज नियर अबाउट 208 डिग्री सेल्सियस. ओके, थीटा जीरो इज, थीटा नॉट इज 200 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो देयरफॉर हियर इफ यू सी थीटा जीरो इज 200 सेल्सियस, टैन एचएमएल एमएम इज 3.65 वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड एंड लेंथ इज 0.1. सो बाय यूजिंग फर्स्ट अरेंजमेंट द हीट ट्रांसफर कोएफिशिएंट, हीट ट्रांसफर रेट इज 91.86 वाट. सो इन सेकंड केस 10 pins with 6 cm length. Okay, so here only n will change. N will be now 10 and length will be now 0.06. Everything will remain same, and by using Q2, by using the 10 pins with 6 cm length, we are getting Q2 as 94.88 watt, which is slightly higher than Q1, that is with 6 pins with 10 cm length. Therefore, second arrangement is giving you better heat transfer as compared to first. Okay, so these type of problem are being asked in the engineering services as well as in GATE examination. Okay, so this was very simple problem. Understood? Any question?
No, sir.
So this was a very simple problem. Please sit with the register, pen and calculator. Okay, don't sit idle. Don't do time pass. You don't have a time. Then we will move towards now second problem. Now second problem is very interesting and good problem. This is a practical problem. You will get the exact understanding of fins and in which fields it can be applicable, you will come to know. Now, what is the problem? Okay, forget about this now. Forget about this wording. Just listen to my word. Okay, now there is a one pump. This is the pump. Okay, now what is the function of pump? To displace the fluid at a some elevation, at some height we have to pass the fluid. So this pump is carrying the what? Liquid metal. This pump is carrying the liquid metal at a 540 degree Celsius. Okay, so this pump is handling the liquid metal at 540 degree Celsius. Okay, and this pump is powered by what? The pump is powered by motor. This pump is powered by motor. Pump is connected to the motor by one shaft, or pump is coupled to motor by using one shaft. Okay, and this is that shaft, and this shaft which is connecting pump and motor is made up of a steel, and its diameter is 25 mm. Thermal conductivity is what? 42.5 kilowatt per meter Kelvin. Okay, now pump carrying the hot liquid at a 540 degree Celsius is powered by the motor. Okay, and this pump and motor is connected by one shaft which is having diameter of 25 mm. Okay, now we have to choose the length. Please listen this speaker. We have to choose the length of this fin in such a way that we have to choose the length of this shaft, steel shaft, in such a way that the motor temperature should not exceed 52 degree Celsius. Are you getting? Motor temperature should not exceed 52 degree Celsius. So we have to choose the length of the shaft in such a way that the motor temperature should not exceed the 52 degree Celsius. Understood? This is our problem. And what at the end of this problem is given? Assume insulated tip condition. What they have mentioned? Assume insulated tip condition. So what we will assume, whatever steel shaft which is used to connect the pump to motor, we will assume this stem shaft as a fin, as a what? As a fin. Which fin? Insulated fin. Okay, so there is only one fin. Are you getting? There is only one fin. And it is insulated one. So here, this fin, steel shaft or fin, this fin is connected to pump. What is temperature of pump? 540 degrees Celsius. So at when the steel, when the pin or the steel shaft has a length x is equal to zero, then what is the temperature at the base of the fin or steel shaft? It is 540. Are you getting? And when x is equal to L, we don't know L. Okay. What is temperature? It is 52 degree Celsius. So when x is equal to L, what is x? Length of the shaft or fin. We are assuming this steel shaft as a fin, insulated fin. Okay. So when x is equal to L, temperature of that fin should be 52 degree Celsius. But we don't know what is the L. So we need to find out the L. Understood? Now you can refer the problem. After you, if you understood this, now you can refer the problem. Now these are the wording of the problem, that an electrical motor is to be connected by a horizontal steel shaft of thermal conductivity 42.56 watt per meter Kelvin, 25 mm in diameter, to an impeller of pump, okay, circulating liquid metal at a temperature of 550 degree Celsius. If the temperature of the motor, okay, is mentioned, the temperature of the motor is limited to the maximum value of 52 degree Celsius with the ambient air at 27 degree Celsius and heat transfer coefficient of 14.7 watt per meter square Kelvin, what length of the shaft should be specified between motor and pump? Assume the insulated tip condition. Okay, so we have to connect pump and motor with the help of shaft. Okay, with the help of shaft in such a way that the temperature of the motor should not exceed 52 degree Celsius. So diameter is mentioned, that shaft is specified by dimension, diameter and length. Diameter is fixed 25 mm. Now you have to find out length. So what we will assume, that shaft is a fin, that shaft is a circular fin, okay, and it is mentioned that it is a insulated, it is having insulated tip. Understood? Okay, so now fin is connecting to what? Two bodies. First one is pump, which is at 540 degrees Celsius, and second fin is at a motor, which is at 50 degree Celsius. Now we will consider this is. Now we will consider this one as a fin, not a shaft. Fin, okay. So when the length of the fin is zero, x is equal to zero, what is temperature at the base of fin? It is 540 degrees Celsius, T naught. When x is equal to L, okay, what? T equal to TL. What is temperature? 50 degrees Celsius. This temperature we have to maintain 50 degrees Celsius. And for that, we need to find out the length of the shaft. Understood? Have you understood the wording of problem?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Problem. Okay. So now we can find out. We can find out. We can apply boundary condition at x is equal to zero, T is equal to 540, and at x is equal to L, what is temperature? 50 degree Celsius. Isn't it? So diameter of that steel shaft, which is nothing but fin, is 0.25 meter. Base temperature is 540 degrees Celsius, where x is equal to 0. T infinity, or temperature of air surrounding, is 27 degrees Celsius. And therefore, we have find out theta naught, that is T naught minus T infinity. It is approximately 513 degrees Celsius. So from this, now first we will calculate M. What is M? It is PH by KA. What is P? Perimeter, pi into D, okay, into H. What is K? K is thermal conductivity, it is given, and into pi by 4 D square, okay. Please find out the value of M, whether you are getting it 12.37 or not. Please don't copy the things, you are not clerk, you are an engineer, okay. So please do the calculation by yourself and just verify the answer. 12.37 is the value of M. Are you getting the value? 12.37.
Yes, sir. M is 12.37.
Sir, 12.31 yeti hai.
Haan, theek hai. Nikhil, Harsh, Ketan Tote. Yes. Okay, you are getting one now value of M. Now, how will you find out the length? Any idea? Anyone can give any guess? How will you find out length?
Sir.
Yeah.
52 degree la motor maintain karayasathi jevda heat flow q chi value jevdi lagel tevdi adhi kadun kheu ani tya q cha value sathi shaft chi length find karu.
Okay, what's your name beta? Nikhil.
Mihir,
we know we have a formula of heat transfer, okay, it's a perfect, but what about temperature distribution? We also have the formula of temperature distribution, na? So we know,
yes,
at x is equal to 0540 and at x is equal to 852. Okay, so we can use that formula. So T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity. Are you getting?
Yes,
sir. Equal to cos ML minus N divided by cos HML. This is a what? Temperature distribution formula. What is T? What is T here? T nothing but TL, nothing but when x is L, hai na? When x is L. What is T infinity? You know that. Atmospheric temperature. What is T naught? You know that. Okay, but we don't know TL. You know TL also, na? Kiti hai TL? Kiti maintain kar? TL kiti maintain kar hai?
52
na? You need to maintain at 52 degree Celsius. So here this is the generalized formula. You know, if you put x is equal to L, because now we want to apply x is equal to L, so this will get cancelled, okay, this will be 0 and cos h of 0 is 1. So this is what TL minus T infinity, okay, T naught minus T infinity is equal to 1 by cos HML. Okay, you know TL is 52. This one is 27. And this one is kiti aaya? T naught 540.
Yes, sir.
540. Okay, so you put everything 52 minus 27 is divided by 540 minus 27 is equal to 1 by cos HML. Okay, you will get the value of length. Tell me the value of length. Tell me the value of L. So this will be cos HML 20.52. Tell me the value.
0.3 meter. Sir, 0.3 meter.
Yeah, 0.3 meter. Correct. So ML is equal to 3.714 and length is 300 millimeter or 0.3 meter. Correct. All of you getting L is equal to 300 millimeter or 0.3 meter?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you need to calculate what? Effectiveness. Also find out the effectiveness and efficiency. So forget about effectiveness, find out efficiency. Find out efficiency. Find out efficiency of this problem. Anyone? Efficiency? What is the formula for efficiency?
Sir, 26% hai thiye ka.
Okay. Gaurav, Niraj, are you there?
Sir, 26% hai thiye ka.
Oh, sir. Aye.
Yeah, you are correct. Shubham Mane, are you there? Shubham Mane. Yash Kulte. Yash Kulte.
Yes, sir.
What is the formula of efficiency for insulated tip?
Tan HML upon NL.
Are Rohit, tula vicharla nahi.
Sorry.
यश भोंगडे आर यू देयर? रुद्राणी पाटील? रुद्राणी पाटील, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मुला फॉर एफिशिएंसी ऑफ अ इन्सुलेटेड टिप?
10 ml अपॉन अंडर रूट ऑफ ha अपॉन ck.
वेरी गुड. नो, यू आर मेकिंग मिस्टेक. फॉर इन्सुलेटेड टिप वी हैव डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला tan hml by ml. And this is for effectiveness. Remember these two formulae: effectiveness, efficiency. Effectiveness will be very less, 0.08. Neglect it because in this problem it is not asked effectiveness. I have added efficiency is roughly around 27%. Find out it. So, are you getting efficiency 27 to 26%? 26 to 27%?
Yes, sir. 26.9.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
That's the correct answer. Effectiveness, you will get 0.08. Okay, now we will move towards next problem. This is also a very good problem. Okay, this is a very good problem, and this is also from GATE. Okay, and it will take only 3 minutes. If you have some knowledge about FIN, it will take only 3 minutes. So what is the problem? I will read it. In an experiment to determine the thermal conductivity of very long, now it is a mention very long, highlight this one, I am highlighting this one, very long, okay, very long solid rod. So in an experiment to determine the thermal conductivity of a very long solid rod of 2.5 centimeter diameter, its one end is placed in a furnace. Its one end is placed in a furnace and rod is rejecting heat into room with a ambient air at 22 degrees Celsius. Okay. After steady state condition are achieved, the temperature at the two points 10 centimeter apart are found out to be 110 degrees Celsius and 85 degrees Celsius respectively. The convective heat transfer coefficient between the rod surface and the surrounding air is 28.4 watt per meter square Kelvin. Determine the thermal conductivity of a rod. Okay, we need to find out the thermal conductivity of a rod. So how to find out that? What is given? What is given? There is a one rod. Okay, and what is the length of that rod? It is not given. Only given the rod is very long. if it is given rod is very long, means the rod has an infinite length. Case number one, pins with infinite length. Okay, understood. So to find out the thermal conductivity of this rod, what we did, the one end of this rod is in furnace. One end of this rod is in furnace. Understood? It is given. What is the diameter of this rod? 2.5 mm. Okay. Then, what is mentioned again, it is rejecting heat to the 22 degree Celsius. Okay, so therefore, the T infinity is 22 degree Celsius and H is 28.4. The most important thing is, after steady state condition are achieved, the temperature at the two points 10 centimeter apart are found out to be 110 and 85 degrees Celsius respectively. So here, what we are doing, we can consider anywhere two points within this rod, which are 10 centimeter apart. And the temperature at the first point is 110 degrees Celsius, and the temperature at the point which is 10 centimeter away from this first point is 85 degrees Celsius. So for simplicity, what I have done, where x is 0, means at the base point where x is 0, I have considered first point. So this is the first point, suppose. This is the first point. Okay. And at the first point, what is temperature? Because the base point T naught is 110 degree Celsius. T naught is 110 degree Celsius. So from here, I have taken now 10 centimeter. Okay, from here, I have taken 10 centimeter. And at 10 centimeter, I have considered 0.2. So this 1 and 2 point are 10 centimeter apart from each other. And at 0.2, what is temperature? 85 degree Celsius. So this is given. Okay. Please read the problem carefully and get it understood. And what is the length of the rod? It is infinite because it is mentioned very long. Okay. And what we need to find out? We need to find out the thermal conductivity of this rod. Can you find out? Can anyone tell me the answer? Thermal conductivity.
Sir, is it 40.68?
So, which case?
Long fin. 40. Infinitely long fin. 68.
Yeah, it is a which case? Barabara. Everything is current, but this position of point is not correct. Okay. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So I have given you one table. Anna? I think you are referring that table. Initially, we have studied two cases, infinitely long fins and long fins with insulated tip, isn't it? So this is the temperature. This is a temperature distribution for infinitely long fins, and this is a heat transfer. Now there is a need of this equation. The need of this equation, because it's a very long fin, and this one also. So initially we have taken only two cases. Then depending upon the ml, we also got short fin. If ml is less than 3, then it is a what? Short fin. And then we have seen short fins, and we have solved, I think, 2 or 3 problem on short fins. Okay, now we will come back to this problem again. So I told you this is a very long fin, means infinite fin. Okay. So what is thermal conductivity? We just have to use this temperature distribution e to the power minus x is equal to theta by theta naught is equal to T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity. Okay, now here what will be, this is a temperature distribution, when what is the x? X is what? It is 0.10 centimeter, no? 0.1 meter. Okay, understood. So replace e to the power minus m, 0.1 m is equal to T means temperature, when T means temperature when x is equal to 10, hai na? When x is equal to 10, so it is 85 minus 22, T naught means 110, when x is equal to 0 minus 22. Okay, so you need to take now, because there is exponential, you need to take the log on both side. Okay, so if you take log on both side, tell me the value of m now. Tell me the value of m. Take natural log on both side and tell me the value of m.
Three point three four.
Yes, sir.
So if you take ln log, whatever, if you take natural log of E, this first component, whatever is in exponential, that will come directly 0.01 m is equal to minus 0.334. So m will be 3.34. Isn't it? M will be 3.34. So please, if you have not noted this problem, please note down this problem. Note down the problem, follow the step, use calculator, find out the answer. That will enhance your understanding. Just by referring the PPT at the end of the chapter will not solve the purpose. So it is mentioned very long. So this case is of, again I'm telling you, infinitely long fin. Infinitely long fin. M is 3.34. M is equal to under root PS divided by KA. Replace M by 3.34. You know H, 28.4. Perimeter will be pi into D. You need to find out K, and area will be pi by 4 D square. Okay. Tell me the value of K. हाँ व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ के?
407.32.
Yes. Tanish Yadav. Tanish Yadav. Thermal conductivity, if you take, it is roughly around 406 watt per meter Kelvin. So it's a very good problem, and it will hardly take 3 to 4 minutes. So in fin chapter, in second chapter, which belong to extended surface or fins, what we have seen? We have seen the temperature distribution and the heat transfer for mainly three cases, isn't it? First case is infinitely long fin. Okay. Second case is the fins with insulated tip, and third case is short fin. Depending upon the value of ML, depending upon the value of ML, the fins can be easily differentiated. If ML value is less than 3, isn't it? If ML value is less than 3, then it is called as short fin. And you need to apply the formula of which fin, short fin. This we have seen. If ML value is less than 3, then short fin. If ML is not defined, okay, but tip is insulated, then it is the case of tip insulation. If ML is equal to 3, then it is called as adequately long fin. Means if you again increase the value beyond 3, there will be no heat transfer enhancement. Okay. The value of Q remain constant even though you increase the value of ML beyond 3. And if value of ML is greater than 3, then it is called as infinitely long fins. Okay, this we have seen. Understood? So for short spin, the formula is very critical and complex. Please do it. Remember. So you need to remember the formula for short spins. This is a temperature distribution. This is the heat transfer. Okay, formula for short spins, temperature distribution and heat transfer, and this table is clearly mentioned two formulae: formula for temperature distribution and formula for heat transfer for infinitely long and long with insulated fins. Understood. So this was just the summary of the second chapter, fins. Okay, we have taken, I think, ample of example. Can anyone tell me the number? How many example we have covered in fins? Anyone? Nikhil, can you tell? Nikhil was absent. Meanwhile, he was absent. Anyone can tell me how many problem we have covered in fins?
Sir, around 6 to 7 problems.
Around 6 to 7 problem we have covered, isn't it? So we have covered the problem from each cases. I think we have covered the problem on short fins also. Short fins, then we have covered the more problem on insulated tip, because it is a what popularly asked in examination. Okay. And we have covered, I think, only one problem on the infinitely long fin today itself. Okay. So now today, tomorrow also we will cover some of the problem, and day after tomorrow we will start with the third unit. Okay. Thank you all of you. Please do your favorite activity and you may leave. We will meet tomorrow at same time. Abhijit and Shrinik, Abhijit Purandare and Shrinik, are you there?